When Sa'd radiallahu anhu was the governor of Kufa, he once came out of the masjid and he saw a large crowd of people gathered. And he asked them, what is the problem? And they said, amongst us is a man who curses Ali radiallahu anhu. He curses Ali radiallahu anhu. And Sa'd radiallahu anhu said, oh my brother, do not curse Ali, for I heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say to Ali, he said, oh Ali, are you not pleased with the fact that you are to me like Harun alayhi salatu wasalam was to Musa, besides the fact that there will be no Prophet to come after me? I heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say this. And the man said, I will still curse Ali. And Sa'd radiallahu anhu said, if you curse him, then I will curse you. And he said, who do you think you are? You think you're a prophet that Allah will accept your curse? And Sa'd radiallahu anhu, he went back into the masjid. He did wudu. He prayed 2 rak'ats, sunnah. And then he cursed this person. And the narration mentioned that they saw a wild camel come into Kufa. And it was as though this wild camel was looking for a particular person. And it came straight up to this person. And it bit him and it trampled him until it killed him. And the people were amazed that how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not only accepted his dua, but at the speed upon which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his dua. The reality is that Sa'd was a sahabi, that nobody would get on the wrong side of Sa'd radiallahu anhu. Because they knew that if this man raised his hands, Allah would accept it. And therefore no sahabi would get on the wrong side of Sa'd radiallahu anhu. Even mountains like Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu were very cautious of Sa'd. Upon occasion, when Umar radiallahu anhu was Amir al-Mu'mineen, one of Sa'd's slaves came out and she had these flimsy clothes on. Silk flimsy clothes, and the wind began to blow, and as a consequence it exposed her body. And Umar radiallahu anhu was Umar, and he had a whip with him. And Umar radiallahu anhu took out his whip and he whipped her. And Sa'd radiallahu anhu moved forward and he whipped Sa'd. And Sa'd fell to the floor. And when Sa'd was standing up, Sa'd raised his hand to curse Umar radiallahu anhu. And Umar radiallahu anhu went running to him and he gave him the whip in his hand. He said, whip me back. Because he knew if Sa'd raised his hands, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would accept the dua of Sa'd.